I think it went so fast. I can't believe that it's almost over. Because life here ends at the time it starts.
It seems like how you mentioned before that they have this mentality to try and make it all about fun, a new experience, something to remember when you get old, which it really is, and that's what it comes down to. But at the same time, I feel like it's really a chance for a person to grow and for a person to really find themselves.
Where we all were about to begin this new life, they said you would change. I've always wondered how. Now I understand, and I think it's worth sharing with people.
I think it's the first time that I was ever like away from a home, like my home for, you know, a long period of time. Like, I was at home for 4 months, and that's the longest time I've ever been away from Minnesota. I've ever been away from my family, which is extremely important to me. And it's a completely different culture. Like, it's still in the US, yes, we all speak the same language, we all still have the same president, but it's a completely different culture.
At first, I was excited when I made that decision, but then when I came over here, it was pretty hard to cope with it. But I mean, as the time goes on, you just realize that you have to accept everything that's happening around you, and it's gonna happen the same way later on. So it's better if you cope with it right now rather than later.
It wasn't easy in the beginning at all. You don't understand what is happening around you. You don't know what a single person to talk to. This is a life lesson you have to learn in order to shape the strongest side of your character.
When I was about to leave Brazil to come here, they were telling me, oh, Americans are so cold. The Brazilian people are the most warm people in the world because we hug each other, because we touch each other. But that's a lie. That's a huge lie. Because I came here and I met people from all over the world, Americans, Europeans, Asians, and we are all warm. When we want to be, we are all humans. We have the same thing, you know? So I feel here now like I used to feel in Brazil, like warm. And I feel like people like me. I feel comfortable around people here. And now I can see Albuquerque, New Mexico, the United States, like home.
I think initially I would be excited, yet at the same time confused and afraid. And I think initially I'd be excited just because I'm out of my own country. I have this cultural awareness that's at my fingertips.
I think one of the most amazing thing about studying abroad is that you get to see a different side of life.
I suppose it's the same experience I get if I were to look at it in their shoes. They're coming to America and get to see it for their own eyes. They don't have to hear it from the media. They don't have to read about it. They get to see it. They get to be a part of it.
Depending on the circumstances, I think you just have to kind of like immerse yourself in that culture, grow with that culture, but also keep your heritage with you.
The confusion would come from, where do I stand? And how do I insert myself into this new environment, this new community? How are people going to interpret who I am as a person versus what they think I am.
The place I came from, it's about Uzbekistan. So you guys, Uzbekistan is unknown, might be unknown for you. Where is it? What is it? Like, is there any country in the map or not? But let me start. Guys, this is national flag.
It's the first time where it's like, I'm the only one watching myself. Like, it's like, you know, you could make these bad decisions and do all these things, but it's like, you have to know at the end of the day, like, it's gonna be you who has the consequences from these decisions and actions, so.
Just the attraction of studying in a different place, in a new community, learning about different people, different cultures, experiencing a lot of things away from your family, being independent, and all those kind of things. I mean,
I'm such a strong believer that diversity is, you know, key for like growth and understanding one another. You have to grow with different people, otherwise you will be very narrow-minded, short-sighted, and you have to immerse yourself with as many different cultures as possible.
That's life, right? You have to keep living and discovering new ways that you could get better in some ways, and you're gonna find out that sometimes you're not gonna be better. You're gonna be worse than you were, you know?
Human.
Yeah, you have to accept certain things and just leave.
Like, the biggest obstacle out of all of them was getting into the culture and fitting into the community. Just, I mean, trying to live a life on your own and doing everything on your own when probably 6 months ago or a year ago, all those things were done by your parents. And for me, the biggest challenge has been like trying to make friends so far. I mean, especially from the United States, because they have very different personalities, they have very different ideologies, and just the way that they're brought up is so different.
Get to know people that we would never know if it wasn't because of this program, you know, studying abroad.
I've heard no more times than I heard yes. And that's why I'm still here. I have my confidence when it comes to my work, even though I may not feel as strongly about it at times. But I know I'd rather do this than anything else at this moment in time. And like I said, life's like a journey. Education's a journey. And this is the journey I want to be on right now. But at the same time, when you're coming to a new setting, you want to experience other things that don't necessarily deal with your studies. Like going out or going to social events.
The best thing is self-challenge. You have to learn how to live an active life. Reading new books, going on a hike, taking your longboard for any day and go for a ride with your friends. And maybe someday your friend would fall apart and broke his arm, and that would be his good, it would be a really good story to talk about.
Just like growing from other people and being able to help other people grow and, like, you know, even help them with their education, like help people with their English and help people like learn things that they never knew, and help, and other people helping me learn things I've never even heard about before. I love hearing about other cultures. I love gaining their perspective on the U.S. Like, be more assertive in my life. Because you need to be, when you're living by yourself, you need to be able to say, like, I need this and I need to do this for my own well-being. And like, I would always rely on my mom or one of my friends to say, like, to call the doctor for me. It's like, no, now that I'm here, I have to do these things by myself. And I think it was an opportunity for me to be able to gain these experiences.
I mean, I'm not saying that I'm doing something good. I'm just saying I'm privileged to be offered the opportunity to take that step. Because coming out of your comfort zone, we all think it's gonna be easy and cozy, but it is not. When you find, even if you find one obstacle, it's really, really tough to face it on your own.
If you go to any culture, you have to adapt.
I'd like to start off by saying that study abroad opened my eyes to a lot of aspects in real life which I would never have experienced if I didn't leave my home country.
It all comes down to a new setting of being dedicated to what you want and realizing that this is your dream. This is something you really want to do. No one's making you come here. This is all you. It's really all you wanting to make this happen. And I think it's possible.
You do change a little bit when you're in a situation where you're not comfortable with. Like, you have to survive in that situation. So your mindset is set to, how can I like be better in this part of the world? Where
I was told from someone like at UNM, Marcus, he was like, you've changed a lot, but like, it's a good thing. I feel
the biggest change that I found was me accepting responsibility for my own actions and my own mistakes. and not finding anybody to blame, because there's no one and it's completely upon you.
Oh my God, I cannot recognize the person that got here in July. Like, I'm a totally different person, but at the same time, I am the same person, you know? Like my values, like the way I see the world, the people, the way I look to myself, the way I understand myself, it's totally, totally different. Like, it's just everything different.
Simple. When I was in Haiti, I never used to wear my hair like that. I was so self-conscious because of my culture, even though most people are black and African descent, they have hair like mine, but it's not accepted to wear your hair like that. But throughout the years, I formed my own identity.
When you experience different cultures, such as like a place like India, you definitely pick up some of the things that they have. So your ideologies mix with American culture and Indian culture. So it's like, India definitely changed me. Like, I was definitely a different person before I went to India. And then when I came back from India, I had, you know, 3 months of knowledge.
Every person that I know from these places, it's a chance that I get to know that place, that specific country.
I think we should understand that we are placed in a different society. Even though you met a lot of new people, by the end of the year, you find a true one.
Here I am.
That was my obstacle, to find the true ones, to come back for them.
Oh, he's shouldered. Ah, very lifted shoulder. Sorry.
I would say studying abroad is like, so it's like a larva. Like, you can compare it to when you come from your country, you're like a larva. And when you study abroad, it's the stage when you go from being a larva, like, to being a butterfly. And when you finish it, is the time that you actually are able to, you actually get wings and you're able to go out into the world and make a name for yourself, probably.
I understand that it may be not the most comfortable for them to try and be so willing to give me themselves, you know, their personalities, their hopes, their dreams, their fears. And it's interesting that there's this willingness to do that, this openness to experience and relate to someone else, versus having your own relation and just having that stuck.
I built new values and I gave up about some values and modified a lot of values, so I'm not the same person. It's complex. I am the same person, but a different person, you know.
Now I feel more comfortable with myself. I think I gained a lot of confidence this year.
I knew who I was before. I was very at ease with my own culture, but coming here, I was able to take different things from the American culture and merging it with my own.
Studying in the United States is a wonderful experience because it helped me to comprehend what I want to do with my life, what I want to do with my professional life, what kind of person I would like to be, what kind of things I want to do in 10, 20, 30 years. Not only it's just because of your place in a different society, but because you tried to get used to know different education system. I love the education system as well. Once you choose your own classes, you tend to get really good at them, and you do because you have so much passion for your classes, because you have so much passion to learn new things. I have learned basic things like doing a good research paper, and just doing a research at all. I'm so grateful for that. I mean, I think a lot of people would have had this chance, and once you have this chance, you have to get the maximum of it because it's a unique chance to grow.
You've essentially made yourself a more diverse person just by intertwining.
When I first came over here, I was really ignorant and really, I would say, obstinate in my thinking, and I wasn't that open towards ideas and opinions of other people. I just understood that it's more about accepting the change, and I was reluctant to accept that change happening in my life.
When I was in Haiti, everything I understood was through my own culture. And I was ignorant about what other people went through.
A better person? What is the measurement for that? A better person is the one who have faced his own bad sides of the character, his dark sins, and turned them into good deed. That's who is the good person, a better person. I think studying abroad helped me to realize my bad sides, my really bad sides, cherish them, and turn them into something really beautiful.
It's a great opportunity for anyone willing to pursue it, because like I said, it adds to your identity. You give a piece to yourself and you're able to get a piece back from someone else.
This is the best year of my life, but the people, by far. Like I can now honestly say I know the best people in the world, like literally world, you know, now, because I've just met so many amazing people. I've learned so much.
What really matters is the friendship that we get here.
To see different cultures rather than something you read on the internet or from a book.
Yeah, it was amazing meeting people from different countries, because it reminded me that it taught me respect for other cultures. So even though we don't understand the culture of the people, but it works for them, so we just have to respect it.
You explore the world. You realize that the world is way much bigger out of your comfort zone. You travel, you meet new people, you get to know different culture. It's like going to 1 year long international conference and learning something new every single day. I think it's a blessing to say that I have a friend in Canada, India, Zimbabwe, Minnesota, Brazil, Spain, Santa Monica, Rochester, Egypt, Germany, Albuquerque, Atlanta. Oh my gosh, this list never ends.
Some of the people I've met here have just been the best for me, and I feel I've been the best for them too. So then I thought, like, everybody was so different, you know? But I really learned that everybody at the core of themselves is the same. Like, it's like, we all laugh the same, we all smile the same, we all, like, we have the same emotions, very similar, and even if, like, someone's English isn't that great, or I don't know any, you know, like, Uzbek, like, we're still able to communicate, and we're able to share experiences, even though, like, we're not able to say it in a language. There's something that transcends language, that it's just the human race, instead of, you know, like, I'm from America, you're from Uzbekistan, you know, so-and-so is from another country. It's one of those things where it's like, we're all just humans. But then, like you said at the beginning of the semester, like, we made our own family here, and we have that sense of, like, community and family that we made.
That's just, I just can't describe it. You have to come here and live, and you will understand. I'm sure you will understand.
Who knows, maybe I would come and see them one day in their home. Also, I wish they would come to see me in my country.